Breast Cancer Awareness Month continues, and Robert Hoggan previously joined and shared his story about losing his wife to breast cancer. Now, today we want to talk about how important early detection is, and more importantly, Robert, I want to talk about the journey that you've been so upfront in sharing with us about how your family has dealt with this whole process. Now, first of all, if anybody doesn't know, please tell the story about your beautiful wife and her journey and her amazing battle against cancer. She was a shining light for so many people.
Thank you for having us. Mm-hmm. Thanks for letting me do this. Sandra was a big advocate for early detection. In 2006, actually a little earlier than that, she felt the lump, and the battle started from there. We waited. We didn't know any better. We was in self-doubt. Mm-hmm. Actually, it was the denial.
Well, and also, too, busy. You know, life was going by so quickly and getting time, but once you realize with breast cancer, the amazing thing that you guys turned around and the focus and the determination, I gotta say, talk about that and how that power was for the whole family.
Actually, you know what, her faith is strong, so that really helped her a lot.
Amazing.
But she's always been a fighter. She's always been one to never give up. She never bowed down to anything else. It's always her fight. Mm-hmm. And for that, when she was the hero of hope for the American Cancer Society, for that, she pushed real strong for that. Early detection and, you know, taking charge.
Yeah, and in taking charge, that was such an important message that she came and she shared with us, I know. Why was taking charge, do you think, so important, especially for someone dealing with cancer? We've talked to people with dealing with cancer now. Taking control over this disease, it's not a control over you. You control it. Can you talk about how important that was, especially for her?
That's a key factor, because what happens is that once you take charge and you fight your battle, it's on your terms. Mm. Even something as simple as losing her hair. We noticed she was losing hair, and what happens is you don't lose your hair evenly. It falls off in patches.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So what happens is we took charge and said, okay, it's going to come off on our terms. So we went over and we shaved her head.
No kidding. Wow. And what was that process like, though, when you take control like that? How did that affect her and then, more importantly, your family as well?
Well, if you see some of the pictures, she's had this long, beautiful hair.
Yes, sir.
And she always had beautiful hair. So we cut it off and we donated to the Locks of Love.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something she wanted to do, something that she took charge with. And then what happens after that was that it came off on her term.
Yeah, I love it.
It was hard when you see it, when seeing the hair coming off and being shaven, you know, tears came out.
Mm-hmm.
And that was something that was special to her. But at the same time, it was under her terms.
You know, we know how special, and we see these wonderful pictures of her with you, your family. I gotta ask, you know, we hear the ebb and flow about how important the strength is from other people when you're dealing with cancer, but we've heard too that sometimes when a cancer survivor is strong and has that thing to take control, the family takes strength from them. It's kind of a both-way
story. Yes, it's a two-way street.
Yeah, can you talk about that dynamic?
What happens was that being that she was so strong, that made us stronger, and when you see somebody fighting it, you want to support her.
Yeah.
So you become stronger and you actually unite, because everything's there for you guys to fight together.
Mm-hmm.
And if you can do something to make her stronger, you will. But not only that you find friends and family and people coming out of the network that you didn't realize.
Really?
People that you didn't expect, and they'll be there for you on the side, and it's like, wow, this is a nice blessing.
You know, and talk about the advocacy that not only spread from her journey, but it's on to you and your family as well. I mean, you guys are continuing this fight, and it's amazing to see that. Could you talk about, especially the kids and what they're doing?
Oh, it's funny, because the kids, they took on, because when we were doing the Relay for Life, the kids wanted to be part of it, and they were team captains.
Really?
They got their friends involved. They got the network, and they started doing the fundraising. Have a friend, Lisa Chunfat. She started a nonprofit organization because of Sandra.
Wow.
It's Pink Lemonade,
It's a great one. We know that one, and it's a great support group. Robert, I gotta ask you one question, and you know, last time we talked, I was bawling, and you were saying the importance of hugging the people that you care about. You never know what tomorrow holds. But I gotta ask, for you going forward, what do you want to see, especially with the legacy of your wife, your family, and so many people she touched here and still touch to this day? But what would you like to see going forward in the future, especially against the battle against breast cancer?
You know, early detection for us, she was a big advocate on that. Mm. Like I said before, we don't know if that would have helped, but it would have been really nice that if we had the chance, if we took the opportunity to find out, then it could have made a world of difference.
Mm-hmm.
Simple things like the mammograms. You know, people don't like them and stuff,
but
they're so important.
Yeah.
doing a self-examination, you probably won't see it or feel it until the size of a pea. Mammogram catches a lot earlier.
Yeah, and unfortunately, by then, when you feel it, it might be too late. So we want to get in early, early detection. It makes a huge difference. Speaking of making a huge difference, I want to take this time, Robert, you and your family, you still every day make a huge difference here, sharing the legacy and the beautiful story of your wife. I want to say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. No. And you are an amazing shining light. Please. Early detection is important. It can save a life of someone you love, someone you care about, or anybody. Just get out there, talk about it with your family, and make sure we end this cancer disease. We hate breast cancer. So we'll keep talking about that, and we'll have links to the website that we want to get people to get aware and talk about the dangers and getting there for breast cancer. Thanks, man. Really appreciate it.